sounded good this week, Sarah.
No, he did. I told him that this morning.
That's Mr. Worldwide. That's Mr. Miami.
Could you imagine him in Miami?
No, that's the funny part. He's like Brian Windhorst, but of Miami.
He's like Sully Jr. down there, just fist pumping with the Jersey Shore kids.
Put the Dolphins hat on.
Oh, I love
it. No, I thought Paul sounded great doing the news.
He was good.
They got to use him more.
But different strokes for different folks.
All right, yeah, that's enough. That's enough out of you.
All right.
You're always uncomfortable. We're just talking.
I'm not uncomfortable.
Take a compliment. Get the hell out of my state. Get out. Grab your credentials at the guard's desk and get the f*** out of here. When is the next season of Billions, damn it?
Probably until next spring, unfortunately.
You shut your whore mouth.
Great show.
Let's go over to Martin Sterling. It's Martin. What's going on, buddy?
Hey, how's it going, Mike?
Good, pal. What's on your mind?
Yeah, I'm here to defend Sully. That backyard baseball series is the absolute best for anybody like in their mid-20s. That's what they grew up with. I agree with Evan. It's really kiddie. But my friends and I, we just love just like grabbing a ton of food, sitting there playing backyard football on PS2.
And said, MP, what to reply?
Having a Pablo Sanchez bobblehead night. And absolutely going to that. You should have Sully look up the Pablo Sanchez theme song for you. So that
wait, forever. These players had theme songs?
Oh, they absolutely did. That Pablo Sanchez theme song is well known among people who played the game.
And by the way, it's the Lansing Lugnuts, yes, who are having Pablo Sanchez.
Thank you. Are you serious? All right, listen now.
On what would be his 21st birthday?
Oh, my Lord. Mark,
it's a cult, Mike. It's a cult.
I never heard of this. All right, listen.
It's so silly, though. It's not like a real game. Like, I get you. Like, the NCAA football games, they were among the best real games. This is a fun, like, just silly, ridiculous game, but having Tom Brady throw it to Marvin Harrison, handing it off to Pablo Sanchez, that's classic right there.
Wait, here's my question. Why would they make a player that's so unfair? You're talking about this kid like he's Mickey Mantle.
Mike Trout.
But here's the thing.
The Mike Trout of the game.
They have skill ratings, and you could get up to four baseballs. It's basically a star system, 0-4. He was 4 in batting, 4 in running, a 3 in pitching, and a 4 in fielding.
So what did it cost you to get this kid on your team?
It was a draft. You said a draft?
Hold on, Martin, stay with me for a minute here. So you're telling me I'm put to a choice that I can draft Peyton Manning or Pablo Sanchez?
Correct.
And if I take the kid, I lose out on, he had to be the number one pick every time.
A lot of the time, yeah.
Absolutely.
This is fascinating. Martin, appreciate this, because Sully was worried nobody was backing him up.
It was such a fun game.
I can't comment. This is the only game that's ever been mentioned here that I've never played. I can't comment on. So, look, in my world, NCAA football, best game ever made. The NCAA 14 edition, best edition. And it's the 5-year anniversary, and that was the last edition because Ed O'Bannon and Satan O'Bannon is a selfish car salesman in Nevada, and he sued, and EA couldn't make the game. Sorry, just had to get that out there. Backyard baseball, never heard of it.
Yeah, there's backyard baseball, backyard football, but like I said,
were any of the other kids any good, or was it just Pablo's neighborhood and nobody else could ever compete?
No, there was a kid named Kenny, always wore headphones, he was okay.
How the hell is he wearing headphones? He's playing sport.
Then the headphones would go over his helmet in football.
What?
a bigger kid, his name was Dimitri, was always my kicker in football. We won so many, it was called Cereal Bowl. That was the Super Bowl, it was the Cereal Bowl. We won so many Cereal Bowls.
Tell you what, that's what the Tigers are going to win this year. The Cereal Bowl. They should have a best of five, like a round robin between the Tigers, the Royals, and the White Sox. The winner, Cereal Bowl.
But yeah, it does look like, it was the Lansing Lugnuts. I might have already done it. But it's join us in honoring the GOAT himself, Pablo Sanchez, on the 21st birthday of the backyard baseball game.
Mike, I feel guilty. I had no idea this existed. I don't know what it is.
Want to hear his walk-up music?
Oh, the hell with it. Sure, we're off the rails. We're talking best sports video game of all time in the midst of Castellanos' defense and Rob Gronkowski's contract. You think we have a plan today?
Here's a throwback for people.
What is he, Zorro?
It was just his thing.
Oh. Oh! they're doing a parade for Greektown. I feel like that should be the track. That's unbelievable. I mean, the audio's terrible.
Right.
Clean it up a little bit.
I gotta try to find a better version.
I mean, 97.1, what the hell are we doing?
Well, I am gonna tell you about Xfinity, because if you want to play backyard baseball, backyard football, you're gonna need internet connection. Actually, you don't, but you're gonna need it anyway if you want to look up stuff. Like, I was just looking up Lansing Lugnuts going on the Pablo Sanchez birthday night or whatever. But point is, Xfinity has the best internet speeds around. It's great. Get it, have it at my house. I've had it for years now. And the best part about it as well, when you have Xfinity internet, automatically get 5 free lines of Xfinity Mobile included at no extra cost. It means you get 5 lines of unlimited talk, 5 lines of unlimited text, and it's automatically included in your Xfinity internet plan to help you save a ton of money on your family plan with your cell phones. You can get started with Xfinity internet for as low as just $19.99 a month for 12 months. Plus, add Xfinity Mobile. 5 lines of talk and text, no extra cost. Call 1-800-XFINITY, visit Xfinity.com, or stop by an Xfinity store today for more details. And remember, like I said, 5 free lines of talk and text is included at no extra cost with Xfinity.
This report brought to you by the Carpet Guys on 75 Fisher northbound ramp connecting to 75 Chrysler northbound. There's still a crash working to clear. It is blocking that ramp. Traffic is already backed up through the area. You'll find those delays right around Rosa Parks. You can exit early at Lodge Freeway northbound to eastbound 94 and rejoin 75 northbound from there. Also, 75 northbound after Grand River, a wreck is blocking the right side. Need new carpet in your house? Skip the cuts and shop at home with the Carpet Guys. The Carpet Guys make it easy to shop local and at a great price. Be wise. Call the Carpet Guys at 855 or my guys. I'm Michelle Pena, the WWJ 24-Hour Traffic Center.
Jamie S. Stoney. Mornings. Coming up Wednesday at 8:02, we'll talk to Tiger manager Ron Gardenhire. And at 9:35, it's Wednesday's Win Blow Show. Jamie S. Stoney. Mornings. 6 to 10. championship game. The shutout Belgium won nothing. Will now meet the winner of Croatia and England, who will battle it out tomorrow. Tigers and Rays, meanwhile, back at it tonight. They're playing the middle game of that three-game set down in Tampa. Matt Boyd against Matt Andrees. We'll have it right here on the ticket starting at 7:10. The Thunder have granted Carmelo Anthony permission to meet with prospective teams. He can be traded to as an expiring contract and then waived. Carmelo already meeting with both Houston and Miami the past few days. From Ryan Mullingmore, 5 or 97.1 the ticket.
Rob Gronkowski. He bros it up. And Gronk's
it up because it's good for business. I respect that. But understand, like, there's a great shot Gronkowski will make exponentially more money in his post-football career than he will make with your team. So while I'll sit here and tell you I think it's ridiculous if the Lions didn't pursue him, because I think it's exactly what you need, it's exactly what your QB needs, we're trying to win, I also can't sit here and condemn any team that doesn't go after him, because I don't know what his buy-in is to football. I don't know if he wants to continue to play. I don't know if he just doesn't up and retire at the end of this year. And make no mistake, money is not an issue. Rob Gronkowski hasn't touched his NFL money. He's lived on his endorsements. Money is not an issue. I think if Gronk wanted to go to television, he'd make $6 million a year. What's he making now? Eight? He wanted to go to the WWE. You don't think he's going to make six, seven, $8 million bucks? I don't know where you're at with it. I don't know if you care. And I'm not doing fantasy factory here where it's like, oh, look, it's a star. Go get him. No, there's a fit here. You got rid of your tight end. You've drafted multiple tight ends that haven't worked out. You have a Patriot coach, a Patriot GM. You've clearly got an offensive coordinator in Jim Bob Cooter who hasn't been able to unlock what he wants. Yeah, if Gronkowski's available, I'm offering the first round pick. And if it's not good enough, it's not good enough. But I gotta have buy-in from the guy that he's gonna play. And the Patriots, look, they do this all the time. They just got rid of Jimmy Garoppolo and look stupid. They're not infallible. Not every move they make is Richard Seymour. Not every move they make is Brandon Browner. Like, they do make really bad moves. They're not infallible. I mean, hell, Brady's 40, and they let their left tackle walk away. Nate Solder. Am I nuts with this, Mike?
No, I mean, as you said, there's nothing wrong with adding more talent, and I think that the Lions, there's no doubt they do a ton of business with the Patriots. And sometimes too much. I think sometimes they do way too much business with the Patriots. But at least this is a guy who could come in and benefit the offense. I'm not going to sit here and say, oh, Stafford needs more, he needs more, he needs more, because I think that's kind of been the knock on him. And I don't
but
think...
But he does, Mike.
Right, and I don't think that the crew around him is anything
Where
special.
Where does your quarterback situation, your quarterback infrastructure rate in this league?
In terms of the help around him, somewhere in the middle.
And you know what? I don't know about that.
15 to 20 range, probably.
I mean, hell, look what the Bears have put around Trubisky. Want to argue it's not better than what you have? Jordan Howard, Tariq Cohen. Good old line. You went out, you got a tight end in Trey Burton. You went out and got Allen Robinson. You're getting back Cameron Meredith, who missed all of last year. You drafted Kevin White, who missed all of last year. You drafted the receiver in the second round, Anthony Miller. I'd argue it's better than what you have here. And if the Bears are better than what you have here, do we need to talk about the Packers? Do we need to talk about the Vikings? I could make a case he has the worst unit in the division.
If they could get him, I'd be all for it.
But don't you worry about his buy-in.
Yeah, Sanders' health a little bit, but yeah.
I worry about every player's health north of, you know, 24, the way this league goes.
Yeah, but I believe he has a very good relation with Matt Patricia, I believe, from what I've seen and read before. So
I'm only bringing it up because it's a clear story and the rumors are back, and I think it is malfeasance as an organization if you're not in on it.
Well, for once, it'd be a decision, a trade with the Patriots that would make sense. The Lions have done so much stuff with the Patriots, a little too much, but this one actually would be something that would make sense.
And again, maybe the Patriots' asking price is silly. Maybe they're asking for three first-round picks or something ridiculous. A Keyshawn Johnson pick. Maybe the Patriots only want him for one. And then, hey, he'll be 30. Let him walk away. We'll move on. I don't know what the Pats are doing.
I did look up his contract. He does have a year after this.
Oh, okay. So I get two?
He has two.
But he wants it restructured.
Yes.
So on his end, it's I'll retire. On their end, it's no, you won't.
Yep.
If I'm getting Gronk for 2 years, would I give up a first-round pick? Yes, I would.
I just wouldn't do it because of injury history and because of commitment. Guess what?
It's the safer side. It's the easier side, smarter side. I am copping to the fact I'm desperate. I want to win.